Hi, greetings and Vanakkam. Today it's our take on this special noodles. It's a bit gooey noodle, but it's although it's gooey, it's damn tasty. This is usually called as Watanho or Kung Fu Chow.
Sometimes they also call it, refer to it as Ying Yong.
This noodles is best eaten when it's already prepared. If you wait too long, the crispiness of the noodles will become soggy. Let me go and give a try to these noodles. Okay, come. This is the noodles. Okay. Wow. See. Okay. Let me go and try this. Okay. Wow, really tasty. The fried rice noodles, they are so crispy. Wow, so yummy. You must try this. This is really awesome. You know, Watanho or this noodles known as Kung Fu Cha, it must be eaten the moment it has been prepared. You cannot pack it home, order through Grab and all that, then it will become very soggy and very soft. You won't get the crispy noodles in your mouth. So the best thing to eat Watanho is either in the eatery or you prepare it at home now because of this COVID-19 calamity. We prepare it at home. It's a very simple dish. Try it out. Okay, let's go and see how to prepare these noodles. Before we do that, I want to show you all this special small gadget which I prepared. See this gadget? It's a mold. It's a mold to fry these noodles, the rice noodles. So that it won't spread all over the wok. So this one I prepared from netting, very fine netting which I bought in the hardware shop. Made it into a round mold, right, so that you can contain the noodles inside here. So if you are able to get this, better. If you are able to do a mold like this to fry the noodles. If not, means you can simply just fry it in the wok. Okay, let's go and see how to prepare this Watanho or this Kung Fu Chow noodles. Okay, come, let's go. Follow me.
Soak 200 grams of thin rice noodles, locally known as mee hoon, for about an hour in a bowl in room temperature water. Pour some generous amount of cooking oil into a frying pan. While the oil is getting heated up, put a mold into the oil so that we can fry the noodles to our desired shape. If not, we'll fry the noodles just like that. Toss the noodles dry in a colander, divide into three portions, and start frying each individual portion separately when the oil is really hot. While we can also fry the noodles unsoaked, it is not advisable as the noodles will get aerated when they are fried. It will make the noodles become easily soggy when the stew is poured over it. Keep them aside when they are done. Pour into a saucepan 1 tablespoon sesame seed oil. Better if you can get the toasted Chinese version. Here we are using the untoasted oil. Nicely coat the surface of the saucepan with the sesame seed oil. Throw in 5 garlic cloves, roughly chopped. Stir in and fry the chopped garlic cloves in the sesame seed oil. Once the chopped garlic cloves turn golden brown, remove them in a sieve and keep them aside. We shall use the remaining garlic flavored sesame seed oil to saute the soft, flat rice noodles. Add into the pan 450 grams of flat rice noodles. Add 1/2 teaspoon dark soy sauce, 1/4 teaspoon light soy sauce. Mix nicely, stir fry and saute the noodles. Once all the noodles are coated nicely with the soy sauces, remove and keep them aside. In the same saucepan, add in 2 tablespoons of cooking oil. Throw in about 4 to 5 thinly sliced ginger root. Stir in and saute the ginger slices in hot oil. Throw in 70 grams of squid, cleaned and cut into bite sizes. Add in 150 grams of boneless chicken meat, cleaned and thinly sliced into bite sizes. Add in 100 grams prawns, shell removed and deveined. Pour in 1 liter chicken stock. You can use store-bought chicken stock. We are using homemade chicken stock. Just boil some chicken bones and skin with mineral water, or just use mineral water will do. Stir in and mix evenly. Stir in 50 grams of thinly sliced fish cake. Cover and simmer until the stew starts boiling. Add in 70 grams of mushrooms. Here we are using brown shimeji mushrooms. You can even use oyster, button or straw mushrooms. Throw in 50 grams of thinly sliced carrot. Stir in 1 teaspoon heaped salt. Stir in 1 1/2 tablespoons oyster sauce, 100 grams of chopped mustard leaves. Clean and chop into 3 cm lengths. Do also add in these stems as they will add a lot of flavor to the stew. Take 2 tablespoons heaped corn flour into a small bowl. Add 1 cup water and stir into a mixture. Stir in the mixture into our stew. When our stew comes to a boil, break two eggs into a bowl. Lightly mix, pour it over the stew like so, and off the stove. Wait for 10 minutes and our noodle dish is ready to be served. Let us start plating with some crisply fried thin rice noodles. Add some of the sauteed soft flat rice noodles. Top them up with the gooey stew which we just prepared. Be generous with the stew so that it soaks up all the noodles. Garnish with the fried golden brown chopped garlic. Come, let us enjoy our labor of love. Looks so yummy. Kung Fu Chow or Watan Ho cannot be any more juicier and crispier than this. Try it out this weekend when you want to spend some quality time with your loved ones. Serve with a dipping sauce. Use light soy sauce and slices of red chili. This dipping sauce will complement our dish very well.
Really tasty. Yummy. The fried rice noodles, they are so crispy. Wow. So yummy.